Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi and welcome back to my channel. Today's recipe is a personal favorite, soft ragi idlis, a perfect healthy breakfast for the whole family. You can see how soft this ragi idli is. Now the best thing about this ragi idli batter is that you can make ragi dosha, uthappam, ragi sponge dosha or even paniyaram with this idli batter. It's a versatile idli dosha batter and also will stay good in the fridge for up to 3 days. Naturally fermented foods, especially fermented whole millets, are a good source of vitamin B12, which plays a crucial role in iron absorption. Ragi is a good source of iron and calcium. Low hemoglobin levels are always a factor with irregular periods, tiredness, high body fat levels, etc. So include fermented foods like idli or dosha, especially if you have health issues like PCOS, diabetes, or simply want to include whole grains in your weight loss journey. I have already shared many ragi recipes along with its health benefits. Please do check them out to understand more. So without wasting much time, let's get started with the recipe. To make ragi idli batter, into a bowl add in 1.5 cups whole ragi. Ragi is also known as finger millet and nachni in Hindi. Into that add in 1/2 cup brown rice. Now this is a local variety of brown rice which has some bran and is not fully polished. However, you can use any variety of brown rice. Using semi-polished rice will give more fiber and is highly beneficial than refined white rice. Add in 1/2 cup whole urad dal, 1 teaspoon methi seeds. Add in some water, wash and rinse it a couple of times. The ragi may have some dust and sand particles as it was bought locally. Once it is rinsed well, allow it to soak for at least 2 hours. 3 hours of soaking would be ideal. Also, soak poha for about 10 minutes. I'm using the red rice poha which I buy locally made from Kerala mutter rice. However, you can use any variety of poha. Okay, now the ragi and dal are nicely soaked. Rinse it a couple of times and then transfer it to the mixie. Add in the soaked poha, add in 1 teaspoon pink Himalayan salt or as needed, add in 1 glass of water. The water should be just above the ingredients. And now grind all this really well and pour it into a large bowl or a container. Cover it with a lid. Note that I am not using a tight lid. We need the wild airborne yeast to help with the fermentation, so aeration is a must. So do not use a tight lid. I usually make the batter at night and keep it to ferment overnight. And the next day morning, the ragi idli batter is fermented well. See how airy the batter is. Naturally fermented foods are an abundant supply of vitamin B12. And vitamin B12 plays a crucial role in iron absorption. To make idlis, I have greased my idli molds with gingerly oil and I'm pouring in the fermented idli batter. Note that it's always ideal to make idli on the first day after the batter is fermented. Place the idli mold in the steamer, cover and let it steam for about 10 to 15 minutes. Once done, open the lid and remove the steamer. Sprinkle little water over the idlis and allow the idlis to cool down a little and then remove it from the mold. See how soft and airy this ragi idli is. Serve the soft idlis with sambar or chutney of your choice. So guys, do try this healthy ragi idli and let me know how it turned out. Don't forget to like, comment and share this video with family and friends. Thank you for watching and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.